Hello everyone, today I am going to talk about neurofibromatosis and how it is caused. Neurofibromatosis is a genetic disorder of the nervous system. It is considered an autosomal dominant disorder because the gene is located on one of the 22 chromosome pairs called autosome. There are three types of neurofibromatosis. NF1 is caused due to chromosome 17, NF2 is caused due to chromosome 22, and schwannomatosis, now it's known as NF3. The gene of this chromosome is still unknown to the doctors. NF is the most common genetic neurological disorder, or the neurocutaneous disorder, that is caused by a single gene. What is neurocutaneous? Neurocutaneous syndromes are disorder that affects the brain, spinal cord, organs, skin, and bones. The disease are lifelong condition that can cause tumors to grow in this area. They can also cause other problems such as hearing loss, seizures, and development problems. The mutation in the genes means that the nerve tissue is not properly developed, and these tumors can develop anywhere on your nervous system, including your brain, skin, spinal cord, and several other organs. It is a most common single gene disorder in human. The tumor in this disorder are usually non-cancerous, benign, but sometimes can become cancerous, that's malignant. Symptoms are often mild. However, complication of NF can include hearing loss, hearing impairment, heart and blood vessel cardiovascular problems, loss of vision, and severe pain. NF is an incurable genetic disorder of the nervous system. It mainly affects the development of nerve cell tissues. Tumors, known as neurofibroma, develop on the nerves, and this can lead to other problems. The tumor may be harmless, or they may compress the nerve and other tissues, leading to serious damage. Neurofibromatosis is a hereditary condition which can appear at any point in a person's life, providing they have the misprint in their chromosomes, which causes it. Because it is a genetic, there is not much which can be done to prevent it from appearing in those affected. A generic mutation, neurofibromatosis, can manifest itself in lots of bumps and tumors across the body. The tumors are usually non-cancerous, but they can appear in huge amounts and in some cases are quite disfiguring. Neurofibromatosis is often inherited, passed on by family members through your genes. It can pass from parent to child, but also 50% of the people are newly diagnosed with the disorder with no family history of the condition. That's because it can result from a sudden mutation in your genes. Once this gene takes place, you can pass this on to your further generations. Sometimes either parents is unaffected, or a random case of genetic change, a spontaneous mutation may happen while the baby is in the womb. Signs are often noticeable at the birth or shortly afterwards, and mostly at the age of 10 years and above. NF can be diagnosed before birth through retinal diagnosis, but this is very rare. NF is not contagious. It does not spread on contact. It does not occur due to drugs, alcohol intake, or X-ray exposure during pregnancy. After birth, there are no specific tests. The diagnosis is made after a clinical exam. To confirm the diagnosis, your doctor may advise a blood test to look for change in the NF genes. So this is the basic information about neurofibromatosis. In my next video, I will let you know what are the symptoms and tests necessary for diagnosis of neurofibromatosis. To stay tuned for my next videos, please do subscribe to my channel and do share and like this video. Thank you. Have a beautiful day ahead. Goodbye.